determined by the hour.
What? What is that thing?
It's the Vizier.
What's happened to him?
Something terrible.
Something wonderful.
Wait!
No!
Be happy that he is gone. You never would have stood a chance.
Oh, how silly of me. You're right. Perhaps we should surrender. Or turn away and leave the city. I know a lovely little island just a few weeks' journey from here. I'm sure by the time we return, this will all be sorted out.
If it comforts you to mock me, then by all means continue. But you are so focused on killing him, you've thrown strategy completely out the window. You could have died.
I suppose. But now we need to find a way to enter the temple. We're wasting time here.
That seems to be our best bet.
You may not be able to see these creatures, but you can still hear them. I'm not sure I like how this girl is always charging ahead.
Fear not. She has already proved a valuable asset to us.
You know, I've been thinking about what Farah said earlier. She has a point. How do you plan to kill the Vizier? He's immortal now.
The dagger made him into what he is. It can unmake him.
I suppose we will know the truth of this soon enough. Before they steal any more from you.
Thank you.
Until all of its guardians have been defeated. Get to work!
Such a beautiful building.
Father built these gardens as a symbol of his love for our people. Once, all the kingdom was like this.
Try using these levers. If I can reach the other side, I might be able to find a way to open that door.
Do you think you could move a little faster?
You're more than welcome to come down here and try it yourself. 7 years, and still nothing's changed.
7 years? What are you talking about?
It's a figure of speech.
There is something very odd about you.
She has no idea.
Ah, we are making progress.
I think I see a bell in that tower. Perhaps if you can get me to the next balcony, I can sever its rope. You can use it to access the door switch.
With my luck, it will probably trigger some terrible trap, or summon sand monsters, or bring about the end of the world.
Would it kill you to show a little optimism?
Experience has taught me wishful thinking only leads to disappointment.
You did it!
We did it.
People hurt inside. We should help them.
Now is not the time, Prince. You can help all you want later.
Go, Farah. Tend to the wounded. I will catch up with you once I've dealt with the Vizier.
And so the prince and Farah separated. She sought to save lives, he to end them. For the prince intended to confront his enemy, and perhaps utilize the powerful warriors who had holed up inside the temple. His mind churned with thoughts of glorious vengeance. But something new as well. Descending into the depths, his thoughts kept returning to Farah. He wondered if she was thinking of him as well. I continue my story from here if you are called away.
Conquer a city is one thing, but to do so with such violence and cruelty is something else entirely. I will return every blow he has landed against my kingdom.
We are close, Prince. So close. Let us make him suffer.
Babylon's last line of defense, fallen. These men served my family well. With their defeat, the city is fully in the hands of the Vizier.
Thank you.
Every time I reach him, he slips away. Why will he not just stay and fight? It would make things so much simpler.
It is not always about combat, Prince. Some battles are waged in other ways, on other terms. I fear we have underestimated our opponent. Let us not make the same mistake a second time.
On the track.
Babylon had finally fallen, and none were left to come to the prince's aid. He was now the city's only hope. If he failed, his entire world could be lost. For the vizier was not content to simply be a king. No. He fancied himself a god. The question now was whether the prince realized the position he was in. And if he did, would he accept this responsibility? Would he become a hero?
Are you all right?
He has escaped. And you, what of the troops?
Dead. All dead. But I saw the vizier, or whatever it is he's become. He flew towards the palace.
Then we know where to go.
All right. But I seem to be, well, stuck. Could you find a way to open this door?
I understand the principles of courtesy, but I think you take things a bit too far.
Thank you, Prince.
Of course. The problem is, now I am trapped.
Just like a woman, solving her problem creates a new one for you.
Allow me to return the favor, then.
You were saying...
Go on, then.
Farah is all right.
You are spending way too much time looking after the girl. Is this necessary?
You sound upset. Are you jealous?
Just focus on getting to the palace.
Should I continue?
All right, then.
There you are.
Keep your voice down. There are enemies below.
Okay. But see if you can do something about these crates. I cannot get past them.
Do you understand now? This is the sort of thing that slows us down.
Thank you.
I can see the palace from here. Make your way to me.
We have returned.
Did you hear that?
If you know what is good for you, say no.
Farah, we must press on. I am sure she will be all right.
Are you mad? She was begging for her life. She said there were others.
No, we can afford no more delays.
Good. Put her in her place.
These are your people. You are their prince, and yet you would leave them to suffer?
That man has taken everything from me. And now that I have the opportunity to punish him, you want to delay me? Have you forgotten what he did to you?
But I...
You are burdened by a guilty conscience, Farah. He made you watch as your people suffered, unable to aid them. You are not to blame. Do not let it cloud your judgment.
It is not I who suffers from clouded judgment. You may choose not to help them, but you cannot stop me.
I go to kill the vizier, to end this, while you run about applying bandages to axe wounds.
Good riddance. She has been nothing but a distraction, always getting into trouble and slowing us down. Finally, we can... What?
Something could happen to her. I cannot lose her again.
No, you're so close.
Farah, where have you gone?
Is this where I should resume the tale next
time? So she had reached the prince. He feared for her safety. Even if it was just one person, at least now he thought of someone other than himself.
Let Farah see me like this.
Worried she will prefer the new you?
Charred skin, glowing eyes, melted face. I'm sure it will be love at first sight.
Better luck this time. Is this necessary?
Yes.
You're sure?
Yes.
Fine. Waste your valuable time rescuing the princess. I can only imagine what the Vizier is doing right now. Probably expanding his army, torturing innocent citizens, deciding what kingdom to conquer next. What he should be doing is dying.
I have not forgotten my mission.
Could have fooled me. Expected quite a bit more from you. On the island of time, you're so focused, so dedicated.
So selfish.
Nonsense. You were simply trying to protect what was yours. Where's the harm in that?
Look around. All of this destruction is my doing.
Traipsing through a brothel while your city falls apart. That's not what I call heroic.
I am here for Farrah.
You're not here for her. You're here for you. She made you feel guilty and you hope to prove her wrong. Your reasons for being here are hardly selfless.
You do not know my motives, and you do not know me.
I am you. And the sooner you realize it, the better.
I have thought about what you said. And you are right. I...
Can't you see we're in the middle of a conversation? If you really do desire death, kindly wait your turn.
I have killed most of the guards. It should be safe. Go and find the women. Free them. I will deal with her.
Wonderful work. You return to save Farrah and send her back to the thick of it while you run after this one. My hero! Following her? Planning on giving chase? Or do you want your enemy to escape? If she mocks you, Prince, go to her. Punish her!
was impressed.
If I had some sands for every time someone said that to me. Oh, I do.
The women are free and headed to safety. It was right of you to return. Prince? You're one of them?
No, Farrah! This is not how it appears!
You're a sand monster! You lied to me all this time!
No! I have been tainted by the sands, this is true! But my mind and my heart are my own! Please believe me!
You stay away from me!
Should I continue? Good. This is a fine place to start the tale next time.
Well, you did lie to her.
No, I simply...
Yes?
But she would not understand. What was I thinking?
Poor Prince. His secret self had been revealed, and Farrah quite disturbed by what she had seen. Perhaps he should have been honest from the beginning. Too late he realized his mistake in staying silent.
Thank you.
Wait!
The prince cleansed himself in the waters of the fountain. Though returned to a normal body, the same could not be said for his mind.
See now! The change was physical, nothing more!
Why should I believe you? Everything you have done contradicts this. I have seen the way you hunger for combat. You take pleasure in creating death. Your constant talk of bloody vengeance. Your cold disregard for your own people. You heard the women in the brothel as clearly as I did, yet you turned away.
But I came back. I came back! For you.
You are a prince in title only. Go and reclaim your throne. But know this. You do so alone.
You certainly have a way with women. Those you don't get killed can't get far enough away from you.
In my youth, I would often lose myself in the back alleys of the upper city. I spent hours running and tumbling, imagining myself all manner of creatures. The rooftops and passageways were secret windows onto other worlds, but now everything has changed. The color bled away, and the sounds of life replaced by a heavy stillness. It has all gone dark and bitter.
Thank you.
palace is close. Let us at last be on our way.
The prince was finally forced to accept the fact that Farah was lost to him, and that he alone was responsible for this. Had he not hidden the truth from her, had he shown more compassion, then perhaps things may have gone another way. But now it was simply too late. In spite of this, or perhaps because of it, the prince found himself profoundly affected by Farah's earlier words and deeds. They had wrought a change in him, slowly supplanting the dark demands of his ruthless alter ego.
What's on your mind?
Perhaps she is right.
Where is the prince I used to know? You are a hardened warrior. Stop being so sentimental. It's not like you.
Were it something I could push away or ignore, I would.
You must try. What lies ahead will be the greatest test you have yet faced.
Tell me then, what do you believe it is to be a warrior?
It is to hunger for combat, to seek solution with the sword. Do you disagree?
Had you asked me when we first met, I would have said the same. Now, I am not so sure.
Think on it then. Okay.
I think. A true warrior fights for something other than himself.
And what of the man that battles to better his own station, to improve his lot in life? Often it is the only way to achieve greatness.
But what you describe is not a man. It is a monster.
I see.
We will have to continue this discussion later.
Is this where I should resume the tale next time? Shall I continue my story from here if you are called away?
What has happened? These people are clearly in danger.
How convenient. A burning building filled with helpless citizens just begging for rescue.
What do you mean?
I mean, it sounds like a trap.
Ridiculous.
Is it? If I was an enraged sand god intent on killing you, and you'd already slain two of my best lieutenants, well, I'd be inclined to try a less direct approach, one that exploits your newfound compassion.
Trap or not, those people need me.
No good will come of this.
Thank you.
I must hurry and find a way inside.
Have fun with that. You can figure it out on your own for once. I will play no part in this.
Come on.